Take it. Take your healing. Take your promotion. Take your job. Take your business. Take it.
Alléluia.
Amen.
Permit me this morning.
Give me the name Jackson.
I may not be able to speak.
Mhlamba ngikwazi ukukhuluma.
Like our father.
Njengobaba.
Because I'm just an helpmate.
Ngoba mina ngisafunda nyanxeka.
I may not be able to deliver.
Mhlamba ngikwazi ukuletha.
Like the assistant.
Njengomncedi.
Because I'm just a mother.
Ngoba ngisafunda.
But I know.
Kodwa ngiyazi.
And I know.
Futhi ngiyazi.
That this morning.
Horekana
God has something for you. And that's why you are here. In the name of Jesus. Close your eyes for 1 minute. And speak unto the Lord. To send a word in your direction today. The word of transformation. The word of encounter. The word that will take you unto your realm of glory. Father, Lord, speak to us this morning. Send your word in a new dimension. I hide myself behind your cross. Speak from the throne of grace. In the name of Jesus. Only you alone. We want to see on this altar. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father Lord. In Jesus' name, we have prayed. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Psalm 139.
Amahubo 139.
Verse 13. For thou hast possessed my reins. Thou hast covered me in my mother's womb. That verse is loaded. For thou hast possessed my reins. And thou hast covered me in my mother's womb. That means from the creation. Mothers have a unique assignment to do on this earth. Because a mother possesses all the reins, has everything. And that's why this morning we are going to be learning about mothers. Because what you don't have, you can't give it. That's why we need to equip ourselves in the name of Jesus. Who
is the mother?
A mother is a carrier and couriers of joy. The book of Isaiah
66
verses 7 downward.
Verse 7.
The Bible says, before she traveled, she brought forth. Before her pain came, she was delivered of a man child. I use this scripture to prophesy to you this morning. Before your pain comes, the answer will be waiting for you. In the name of Jesus. Verse 8. Who had such a thing? Who had had such a thing? Who had seen such things? Shall the earth be made to bring forth in one day? Or shall a nation be born at once? For as soon as Zion traveled, she brought forth her children. A mother is a carrier of joy. In this new realm of yours, as a mother, you will bring forth all your joys, all your blessings in the name of Jesus. Verse 9. Shall I bring to birth and not cause to bring forth? Said the Lord. Shall I cause to bring forth And shall the womb say thy God? There shall be no barrenness in your life. I said there shall be no barrenness in your life. Every dryness, they are turning to joy this morning. In the name of Jesus. Verse 10. Rejoice ye with Jerusalem, and be glad with her, all ye that love her. Rejoice for joy with her, all ye that mourn for her. People will gather together to celebrate you. In the name of Jesus. Verse 11. That ye may suck and be satisfied with the breast of her consolations. That ye may milk out and be delighted with the abundance of her glory. Everything that it takes to be a mother, the Lord will give it unto you. In the name of Jesus. Verse 12. For thus said the Lord, behold, I will extend peace to her like a river, and the glory of the Gentiles like a flowing stream. Then shall ye suck, and ye shall be borne upon her side, and be dandled upon her knees. Every glory of the mother to be a carrier that the Lord has destined you to be, they shall be given unto you this morning. In the name of Jesus. Verse 13. As one whom his mother comforted, so will I comfort you. And ye shall be comforted in Jerusalem. The Lord of hosts will comfort you round about in the name of Jesus. So shall it be in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Number two, mothers are fruitful vine of the world.
Oh, mama, abantu abagcwele ithelo emhlabeni.
You can call mothers anything you can think of. Anything you can think of. If you like, you can say mothers are the salt of the world. If you like, you can say mothers are the honey of the world. If you like, you can say mothers are the juice of the world. Even if you like, you can say mothers are the pap of the world. It depends on what you like. Whatever you like most, you can use it to describe a mother. Because mothers are fruitful vines. Mothers are our pride. The book of Ezekiel, chapter 19, verse 10. Thy mother is like a vine in thy blood, planted by the waters. And she was fruitful and full of branches by reason of many waters. Amen. Mothers are fruitful vine.
Oh, mama, by eating.
The Lord water mothers.
Oh, mama, oh, nama.
To bring forth fruit.
Oh, mama, maga mvume.
The Lord bless mothers.
Mamele, oh, mama.
To bring forth fruit.
Ukuthi akulethele ithelo.
And to nurture them.
Akwenze ukuthi utheleke
nama. You know a plant.
Wena ube isitshalo.
That doesn't get water.
Esingeke sithola amanzi.
You dry off.
Wena uzova.
For a water, a plant.
Isitshalo.
That get waters.
Esithola amanzi.
Sufficiently.
Esikhathe kuyisona.
We blossom.
Siyathela.
That is what mothers have.
Yingako, oh, mama, bekho.
The Lord Almighty.
Unkulunkulu.
We make you a blessing.
Uzokwenza isibusiso.
Unto many. That the Lord has given unto you. In the name of Jesus. Mothers are givers of life.
Oh, mama, banikeza impilo.
Mothers are holders of life.
Oh, mama, baphatha impilo.
Mother gives life.
Oh, mama, banikezana ngokuphila.
Mother nurtures life.
Oh, mama, banikeza impilo.
Father produce.
Oh, baba, bayiletha isithelo.
They donate.
Bayathela.
And they live.
Bese bayahamba.
Mother carry.
Oh, mama, athwale.
And bring forth.
Athele futhi.
And nurture them.
Akhulise.
And bring them to another.
Aphakamise futhi
baba. And that is why
yigago.
You are here this morning.
Namhlanje ukhona.
We don't just donate.
Asitheli thina
kuphela. We don't just give. But we nurture. We carry with care. We carry diligently. And we bring forth into another. And that is why.
Hallelujah.
you are here this morning. In the name of Jesus. Take care of your mother. Mother don't just donate. But we nurture. You see how this man with
Biabie?
A mother nurture them and bring them forth. Permit me to even see our father and the second father. A mother nurture them in the name of Jesus. Clap for yourself.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Mothers are the controller of this world.
Oh, mama,
either biological mother or marriage mother.
Or mama was
because by marriage,
mama,
a wife is a mother.
Oh, mama.
I don't want pastor to hear this.
Angifunde.
Your husband.
Wako.
Our husband.
Betu.
They are like babies.
Betu.
They are like babies.
Betu.
I hope pastor doesn't hear me. Hallelujah.
Amen.
We control the whole world.
Si
a mother controls.
Si
mother controls
oh,
the whole world.
Pete,
even the president of a nation.
No mama futi, oh, ubaba,
somebody
president.
Is in the corner.
Ukono se kone.
Say, Ura Maposa.
Uma, Ura Maposa.
Hey, wena.
Hey, nina.
You must do this.
Panele, wense, logo.
I don't want to mention the name.
Angfunu bizikama.
But we have one president before.
God, I besino mwenye president.
If mothers were to be dictating for that one.
Uma, abo mama, begna tiwo kutine ngabo.
Because mothers were many. There were so many. But there will be one person who will be ruling in his corner. In our corner. But let me warn you. Mothers rule. Make order in a good way. Don't rule in a bad way. Because concerning every nation, concerning every organization, a mother rules. But rule well so that God can bless you in the name of Jesus. Number five, mothers are destiny helpers. Mothers are destiny helpers. Remember, we bring forth. Mothers know how to mold your destiny. A child that wants to go wayward, the mother knows how to bring forth, how to take you into a normal way. If you are going in a wrong way, the mother will shire you, scold you, correct you, and put you through. Mothers are destiny helpers. Listen to them. Don't say my mother is tough. Experience is the best teacher. Don't say you are not mother. When you are BBT, born before technology, you don't know what's up. Mother may not know what's up, but she knows better. Listen to them. They are destiny helpers. In the name of Jesus. Number six. Mothers,
oh mama,
are mini God on earth. Remember, mother gives life. Assume when your mother was pregnant of you, or they were pregnant of me or her, and she aborts the pregnancy. How are we going to be here today? God created, and the same God give that power unto us as a mother to create, to nurture. Remember, it's just one egg. A mother nurtures, give lives, and bring forth unto the world. Mothers are mini God on earth. Even God himself who now bypass mother when he wants to send Jesus Christ. That is how important you are as a mother. Put your hands together for yourself. Let's check that.
As begini logo.
In Matthew 1 verse 18.
Matthew 1 18.
The birth of Jesus Christ.
Ukuzalwa kuka Jesu.
Matthew 1 18.
Matthew 1 verse 18.
Now the birth of Jesus Christ was on this wise. When as his mother Mary was espoused to Joseph, before they came together, she was found with child of the Holy Ghost. It's not that God cannot do it by himself. God can just wake up one day and throw Jesus from heaven. But God wants you to know the importance of yourself in this life, and that is why God has to pass through a mother. That is to say, God has automatically given the affairs of this world unto mothers. Because without mothers, there is no life. There is no life. That is why you are important. With mother,
no mama,
there is life. And don't forget, every motherhood starts from womanhood. Every motherhood starts from womanhood. Without woman, let me call it like our country. Without women,
there's no mother
at all. Hallelujah.
Okay.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
That is why you have to respect mothers. Respect mothers. Respect mothers. Not only your mother.
I mean
by blood. For every mother around you, respect them in the name of Jesus. Even Jesus Christ in the book of Mark 3:34, and Jesus said,
what to Jesus?
And he looked around. Mark 3:34, and he looked around about on them which sat about him, and said,
what?
Behold my mother and my brethren. Mother first. Even Jesus. Mother first. Before the brethren. Not you of these days. My friend. Supersede my mother. Because she knows what's up. Because he knows what's up. When mother first. Mother first. Before anyone. And who is the mother of Jesus? Mary.
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 Who is Mary?
Amen.
Amen.
Let's study the ministry of Mary.
Mary.
That will be a blessing unto somebody here this morning. Because God is about to drop something into our lives in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Luke 1:27. Luke 1:27. To a virgin espoused to a man whose name was Joseph of the house of David, and the virgin's name Mary. Mary is the mother of Jesus. Mary knows no man. Every mother that wants to be extraordinary. Every mother that wants to be an exceptional mother must learn to behave like Mary. But let me warn you. Mary know no man. As a mother. As a mama.
Mama
nkeza ndota yako.
Mama nagegela umyeni wako. Look after your husband.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Don't try this at home.
Ne?
Ne? Mothers,
oh mama,
don't try this at all. Uyahali, don't deny them.
Ungali,
don't deny your husband.
Uskakana.
Doctor's prescription.
Uskaba, mutu omu.
A tablet in the morning.
Upuzipilisi.
A dose in the afternoon.
Upuze futhi nasemini.
Top up in the evening. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I don't say that. Let's continue. 2 Timothy chapter 2, amen, verse 22. To be a woman, flee also youthful lust, but follow righteousness, faith, charity, peace with them that call on the Lord out of a pure heart.
Ukuba umama, ukuba musha balekela inkanuko yobusha. Ukuzube umama oqotho.
God used Mary.
UNkulunkulu wasebenzela sisu
Mary. Because Mary was available.
Ngoba uMary wayekhona.
Are you available for God?
Wena ukhona for uNkulunkulu.
Make yourself useful.
Zenza ukuthi usebenzise.
Make yourself available.
Zenza ukuthi ube khona.
Make your body a temple of the Lord.
Yenza umzimba wakho ube itemple
likaNkulunkulu. Have faith in God.
Hlala kuNkulunkulu.
Let there be peace all around you.
Makube nokuthula kuwe.
This one you carry face like this.
Hayi ukuthi njalo uthwele ikhanda.
How are you, mommy?
Uyabulisa. Uthi kuhle.
How are you, mommy?
Unjani?
For what?
Awufuni kukhuluma.
For what?
Ukwatile.
Make peace.
Iba nokuthula.
With everybody.
Naye wonke umuntu.
Let charity be your watchword.
Yenza ubuhle.
A mother gives life.
Umama uletha ukuphila.
Don't withhold.
Ungayenzi ukuthi.
Whatever that the Lord has given unto you.
Umntana le akupha yona.
Whatever you are.
Noma ngabe yini oyiyo.
As a mother.
Njengomama.
Share it.
Nagegela uphe wonke umuntu.
That's a mother.
Umama lo.
The Lord will help you.
UNkulunkulu
uzonisiza. In the name of Jesus.
Yegama lika Jesu.
What are the characteristics of Mary?
UMary bekuwumuntu onjani?
What brings Mary, the mother of Jesus, to limelight?
Yini leyenza ukuthi uMary adume kangaka?
One.
Wokuqala.
Submissive spirit.
Wayenomoya wokuyithoba.
Mary submit to God.
UMary wayethobile kuNkulunkulu.
And her husband.
Nomyeni wakhe.
She submit to the authority.
Wayehlele ngisho umthetho.
Of her husband.
Omyeni wakhe.
Not like our people of today.
Hayi abantu banamhlanje.
If the daddy say one.
Uma ubaba athi one.
You will say 1, 2, 3, 4.
So it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 10.
Because you are educated.
Ngoba ufundile.
Because you are earning much.
Ngoba unemali.
If daddy says sit.
Uma ubaba ekhuluma.
You will say for we.
Wena uthi ini?
Equal rights.
Beka mina nginamalungelo.
Equal rights. That is what the law says. Mary wasn't like that. Be submissive to your husband, to the authority, and to God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The book of Matthew, chapter 2, verse 13.
Amen.
And when they were departed, behold, the angel of the Lord appeared unto Joseph in a dream, saying, I want you to underline that. The angel of the Lord appeared unto Joseph, not to Mary this time around, saying, arise and tell the young child and his mother, and flee into Egypt, and be thou there until I bring thee word. For Herod will seek the young child to destroy him. The Lord appeared unto Joseph.
UNkulunkulu wavela kuJosepha.
And not to Mary.
Hayi kuMary.
But Mary submits.
Kodwa uMary wayithoba.
Mary submits.
Wayithoba.
Unto the husband.
Kumyeni wakhe.
Verse 12.
Verse 12.
14, sorry. Verse 14. When he arose, he took the young child and his mother by night and departed into Egypt. If you don't submit, you may lose your fruit. As a mother, Mary did not ask questions. Why? How? Because of what? Why must I follow you to carry my baby? For what? Submission. Mary did not ask questions. And that is why these days, if you see some people, you will know where they are coming from. Because like mother, like family, submission, be submissive.
Yes.
Unto your husband, unto God, and unto the authority. In the name of Jesus. Number two, Mary as a mother is not a talkative. It's not a talkative. Don't talk too much. She keeps herself to be an exceptional mother. You need discipline and to wait unto God. Wait for direction. The book of Matthew 2:13. The same story we read to 14 before. Mary was very secretive. Positively. Not that when the husband said, the Lord said we must take this baby, you carry your phone. Me and my baby now, we are departing.
We are shooter man.
On to,
we are reporter.
Now,
manje,
my husband said, we must carry this baby. And we are going. Friends, still on the same matter. We are crossing Alexandra Bridge now. Without my newborn baby. I went now. Don't talk too much.
Don't talk too much.
Small, small.
Kancane.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Limit social medias.
Beka ukuthi ubhalane la ifonini
yakho. When it comes to secret things,
izinto eziyimfihlo.
The secret belongs to the deep.
Izinto eziyimfihlo zifihlekile.
Keep it there. Don't throw it. Limit it. Not all the secrets. Go on social media. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Number three. Mary suffers an humiliation from people just because of her children. And she refused to give up.
Umeri manje uyahlazeka ngenxa yabantwana bakhe kodwa zange alahlele ithawula.
An exceptional mother.
Umama ohlukile.
Don't give up.
Aka give up.
Don't give up.
Aka lahlele ithawula.
Either in mockery.
Noma bemhleka.
Or in humiliation.
Or bamehlisa.
Keep moving.
Uyaphambili.
Keep moving.
Uyaphambili.
Keep moving.
Uyaphambili.
Don't give up.
Unga give up.
Because God.
Ngoba uNkulunkulu.
Will not give up on you.
Angeke give up kuwe.
Keep moving.
Hamba uyaphambili.
In every situation, I don't know what is mocking your life. But I decree to your life this morning that mockery has come to an end. In the name of Jesus, God Almighty, the God of 72 hours, we put a smile on your face. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Mary overcome.
Number
by being contented.
Ngokuthi ajabulele lokanako.
Despising all the present.
Noma ngabe bekwenzakalani.
But looking at the future.
Kodwa wabheka kusasa.
For the promise.
Ukuthi isithembiso.
For you to be an exceptional mother.
Ukuthi ube umama ohlukile.
Don't look at the present.
Musa musa ukubheka isikhathi samanje.
Whatever you may be going through now.
Noma yini enzakala
manje. It's just a phase.
Isikhashana.
That is not your place.
Ayiyona indawo yakho.
Because God is preparing something.
Unkulunkulu yakulungisa.
Big for you.
Enkulu yesa.
Wait unto that promise.
Linda kuleso sithembiso.
Wait unto that promise.
Linda kuleso sithembiso.
Luke 2 verse 7. How many mothers can tolerate or can do what Mary did? And she brought forth her firstborn son and wrapped him in swaddling cloth and laid him in a manger Because there was no room for them in the inn. Be contented with any situation you are. Don't put your husband into debt. Not everybody can give birth by Gardic Field. Not everybody can give birth at Link's Feet. Whatever that is available, live with it. Because life is in phases. And men are in sizes. Be contented. Be contented. If he is pep now, celebrate God for it. If he is jet, celebrate God for it. Whatever it may be, celebrate God in your own way. Mary was contented because she knows that the pressure of today cannot be compared to the glory of tomorrow. That will be your testimony in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Number five. Mary did not treat Jesus like a child alone. That is no over familiarity. As an exceptional mother, recognize the potentials in your children and appreciate them. There is no useless child. For every child, for every creation, we are born with a purpose. Recognize it as a mother and help that child to develop it. Don't let them throw away their potentials. Because for every children, God has deposited something in them. Recognize it and appreciate it. Don't say you are useless. Nothing is good in you. Whatever the case may be, appreciate God for that child. Recognize something that is working in that child. If there is nothing to appreciate God for, for the fact that you give birth to that child alive and healthy, is a reason enough to thank God for God to reveal the potential in that child. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
Number seven. Number six. Mary did not abuse the lordship of Jesus. To be an exceptional mother, don't abuse the office of your child or your husband. Respect their opinion and their authority. Remember, I said mothers, they rule. How are you ruling? In your own corner. Mary did not abuse the lordship of Jesus Christ. For example, I have police in the house as a daughter. And I will go out there and make trouble. And I will be telling them, when, don't you know that my daughter is a senior police officer? That means I'm abusing her office. Don't abuse their office. Don't abuse their authority. Respect them. Respect them. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Number seven. Mary has faith in his son. Mary initiated the first miracle in the life of her son. Remember that wedding in the Cana of Galilee. When their wife finished, Mary is the one that was telling them, whatever he asks you to do, do it. Because he believes in him. She believes in the son. As a mother, to be an exceptional one, you need to believe. You need to have faith in your child. Don't tell him or her. What can you do? When?
We poison when.
Everybody is talking, you two are talking. How many talkers are here? Who put words in your mouth? Mothers.
Oh, mama.
Don't murder them. Don't do that. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah.
Amen.
What are the things to do in summary? To be an exceptional mother. That extraordinarily mother. The mother that Christ is looking for. What is it that is expected of you? Hallelujah.
Amen.
Number one. Don't despise yourself. Don't despise yourself. Bring out the best in you in every situation you find yourself. Don't allow any evil to whisper nonsense things to your ears. Whatever happened, whatever the situation, be prayerful and don't despise yourself. For example, somebody might have a child out of wedlock. It's not a good thing. The Bible doesn't accept it. But the deed has been done. But somebody, we hate that child and hate herself to the extent that even looking at that child, a thought will be going on in your mind. When you did Satan, you are the one that did not make me to be happily married now, and that will be making you to wear a long face. Anywhere you go, you wear a long face. Anytime you want to pray, something will be telling you, but I'm not righteous, but I've got a baby out of wedlock. What will I say to God? When
you,
the grace is available. The grace is available. Don't die in that situation. Shake it off and move on. Believe in God for the best in every situation. The devil may be whispering to you, nothing is good in you because you were raped when you were young. And anytime you remember that, I'm not even beautiful again because they raped me, I cannot get a good husband. When
you,
there is power in the tongue. Yesterday has gone. Forget about it. Face the present and think of the future. God still cares. And His grace is enough for you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Number two. Pray to make things happen. Don't just sit in that situation. Everything is difficult. Things are tough. What must I do? Ufuthi, you are the head. I'm just the neck. It's your problem. No! Mothers are prayer warriors. If you see a man glowing outside, somebody is there at the upper room interceding, praying, asking God, what next? What will happen? This is my end. It should not get rotten. Pray for things to happen. The Lord will give you power. In the name of
Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Number three. Be contented. In every face. In every situation. Fingers are not equal. The agenda of God for you is different from mine. A king reign at 8 years. Another one reign 40 years. They all do what? They all reign. Be contented. Whatever the situation may be, don't push him. Don't push your husband to do what is not correct. The kingdom of God is correct. Be that mother that will be content with the situation and go on her knees, eyes first up, to ask for help in times of need. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Number 4. Be submissive. I used to tell people, gentility is no humility. I may be gentle, but there is no humility. Some people, if you see them outside, hallelujah, amen. Good afternoon, good morning. But if you see them at home, fire! Hey! Don't do that. It's not correct. Ayeke.
Never.
Ayeke.
Never.
Don't try that at home. Because one day, that head may get provoked and clap you. What our father will say is, apologize.
Police.
Apologize.
Police.
Tell her sorry. Embrace her. But that clapping has gone. So please, be submissive in every situation. Be submissive to your husband. Be submissive to God. Be submissive to the authority. Submission is not stupidity. The more you submit, the more this comes out. Ne? Do you get it? I don't want to say it because my own ATM is here. That's why I don't want to say it. But you need to be submissive. If you are submissive, this comes small. It comes small. Be submissive. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Number 6. To be an extraordinary mother. To be an exceptional one. To be an exceptional one. Linga kulumi kakulu.
Don't talk too much.
Ne?
Yebo.
Ne?
Angithi.
Tell your neighbor for me.
Tshela umakhelwane ukuthi vala. Vala la. Apa pa 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 vala.
You know some people, they will not wait for their testimony to be matured, and they will use their mouth to kill it themselves. Ah, sister, do you know Brother James wants to propose? He told me by 6 months he will propose me. The Lord will help you. That brother will propose. So. Wait for your testimony to mature before you share it.
Before ukuluma.
Don't share testimony that is not mature. I'm trying to do a bond. I want to get a house. Hey, mama. I'm sure by July, you will come to dedicate my house. It's good to have faith. Have faith. But don't talk too much. Don't be a talkative. Allow your testimony to be matured before you share it. Otherwise, that testimony may be corrupted. Because you see face, you don't see the stomach. Allow your testimony to be matured before you share it. Mary waited. People are mocking her. She doesn't care. When the husband says, let's carry this baby in the middle of the night, she doesn't go on Instagram and say, my followers, this baby is moving from this city to the next city. Don't talk too much. Anytime you talk too much, you can make mistakes. Mothers,
oh mama.
Mothers,
oh mama.
Mothers,
oh mama.
Learn to control your tongue. That may preserve your fruits. Learn to preserve your fruits by not talking too much. Wait for that testimony to mature before you share it. The Lord will help us.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Number 7. To be an extraordinary mother. An exceptional mother. Does not care about mockery and humiliation. Because you know that God is preparing something big for you. For the fact that there's a mistake today, for the fact that I am here tomorrow, does not mean I cannot be here next tomorrow. I'm a very good example. When I enter into this country
South Africa,
with my husband with master degree and a
PhD student,
I was working with someone that is cooking food. I will cook the food and carry that food on my head to the mechanic village in Dorfontein. I don't cook my no money. As I'm selling, my boss is collecting the money. When we got to the house, the same my boss, we count the money and sell the raw food that I will cook the next day. And tell me, I just arrived this country. For you to make it in South Africa, you must pay the price. You will get the money, but wait first. This money is not enough. Let's keep selling. With joy, I don't care where I'm coming from. I don't care my own education status. I don't care my post. Where I'm coming from, but I'm doing it with joy. I'm doing it excitedly. And one morning, we cooked this food. And the rain fell that day. There was rain. I carried this food to the same mechanic village. And my boss left me there. That she wants to go, she's coming back. Remember, I don't know money. I only know if you give me 20 rand. I will look and calculate, so she doesn't allow me to collect money. That day I collected money. And when she came back, I gave her all the money. This is what we make. I don't even know either people are laughing at me or not. Whether people are laughing at me or not. But when we got home, I told my husband, my dear, you know what happened today? I make money. I saw 100 like 3. 20, they were like 20. Because my boss couldn't come on time. And my husband has said, then how much is your own? Dololo.
Luto.
And Baba said, ask your boss. Because we are staying in the same house. And I call her, Sister Dami, what is my own today? She said, is it because you are the one that make the money today? There is still more food. You didn't sell everything. So you can eat. Then let's buy raw food again. Then my husband said, no. You need to stop. I cried because I love what I'm doing with humility, with submission. I am doing that thing. I did not care whether people are laughing at me or not. But that experience make God to prepare me for myself in this country. Whatever you may be going through, settle it in your heart that God is preparing you for a bigger stuff. Settle it in your heart that you are going somewhere. Because the suffering of today cannot be compared with the celebration,
Nenjabulo,
with the joy,
Nenjabulo,
with the blessings
Nenjabulo,
of tomorrow.
Zaksaza.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Be ready.
Zimisele.
Number 8. You must always be ready
Njalo zimisele.
To face challenges.
Ubhekana nezimo ezinzima.
And be strong.
Uzokwazi ukuqina.
For yourself.
For wena.
And bring out the best.
Ukhiphe okuhle.
In any situation.
Noma ngabe yisiphi isimo.
There is no worse situation.
Akuna simo esisodwa.
No hopeless situation.
Asiko isimo esingenzeki.
Because in that deep.
Ngoba mina.
There is God. In that situation, there is God. No hopeless situation. Whatever situation, in any situation, you find yourself, bring out the best. Face that challenge. Real mothers, they don't run away. For challenges, they face it and conquer. And that will be your testimony. In the name of Jesus.
Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And as I'm rounding up, aspire to be mother of nations. That is what God created you to be. And not a murderer of nations. What I'm saying in essence, your role as a mother in any situation you find yourself is to bind people together. Keep them together in your community. Keep them together in your family. Keep them together in your environment. Keep them together even where you find yourself in the midst of strangers. Keep them together. That is God wants you to do. No indigent or stranger, but anywhere you find yourself as a mother, keep them together. Bind them together. That is the will of God. Mother them together, and a strong nation will emerge. Particularly in church, particularly in your department, particularly in that small gathering that you find yourself. Bind people together. Mother them together. Don't discriminate. God doesn't discriminate. Milk is thicker than blood. Milk is thicker than blood. Do you want to know the meaning? They don't want to know. You used to say water is thicker than blood. Now I'm telling you, blood is thicker than milk. Sorry. Blood is thicker than milk. Don't discriminate. What do I mean by that? My own milk sisters and brothers, the one that were born by the same mother, were they here with me this morning? Not all of us have that. The one you suck the same breast, they may not be where you are, but the people of us of faith, the same blood, bind me and you together. You are my blood sister. He's my blood brother. You are my blood mother. And that is why I have to celebrate you in every situation. Because blood is thicker than milk. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Clap for me. Amen.
Amen.
Another one for Mama Fire. To have a healthy church, for the church to be healthy, it takes an exceptional mother. Only Mama Tao cannot do it. Only Mama Fire cannot do it. Only Mama Tina cannot do it. But in that department, where you find yourself, you are a mother. Mother them together. Don't mother them. Don't mother them. Please, I'm begging you. Don't mother them. Bind them together. Because that is the will of God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
All things have been said. I've been talking since about what is expected of a Christian mother, of an exceptional mother, of an extraordinary mother, which I know you are the one this morning. Everything God expected from us, we might be falling short in one way or the other. Some of us, what we don't want to do is what we keep doing. You need grace. Tell your neighbor you need grace for you to fulfill destiny. You need grace for you to fulfill destiny. You need grace because everything that God has given unto you, you will answer for them when you get there. But my prayer for you as a mother this morning is that you will not lose your throne. You will not lose your crown. You will not lose your mansion. On that day, the cry of go, I don't know you, will not be your portion. In the name of Jesus. It is the feather of a father that makes you to fly higher.
Hallelujah.
The feather of a father makes you to fly. At this juncture, I want to invite my father, my mentor, my chocolate, my advisor, your father, your bishop, to come on this altar and decree that grace in our life that will carry us through. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah.